Herbicide resistance is the inherited ability of a plant to survive and reproduce a herbicide dose to which it was normally susceptible. And it occurs through a selection process of using this herbicide over a continued period of time. The issue with resistance is that some types of resistance may have a fitness penalty to them. Unfortunately, that's more of a rare occurrence. So historically, early on in the 80s, 70s and 80s, with triazine resistance, there was a fitness penalty due to the fact that it wasn't as photosynthetically as efficient. With our resistance we have now, glyphosate resistance, resistant to ALS herbicides, there's no real fitness penalty. So therefore, those traits tend to stay in the seed bank, in the genetic code, and they're passed from generation to generation, which is creating some other issues for us, primarily multiple resistant weeds. Herbicide mode of action is a four-step process, really, where how an herbicide kills a plant. And so basically it starts with coming in contact, the herbicide in contact with a plant, being absorbed by the plant, and then moving in the plant and reaching toxic levels at the specific herbicide site of action. There's different steps in that mode of action process that I talked about that would result in some resistance. So it could be differences in absorption and uptake in the plant. That's one mechanism. It could be altering in that biochemical site of action that I talked about, the end step. And it also could be that it may be broken down before it ever gets to a lethal level in the plant, so it could be metabolized. So there's a lot of different steps, different mechanisms. It adds uncertainty into the management process. So it's very difficult to know what's going on in the field and how to address it. So it just adds another level of uncertainty in managing the resistance problem.